Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Bharat Test Guru. Today we're gonna talk about the concept related to the financial market, that is capital market. From this financial marketing concept, questions will be asked in our exams like IBPS and SSCE. As we know, the financial market is of two types. Those are money market and capital market. We have already completed the concept money market in the previous sections, like what is money market and instruments available in money market and concepts related to them, treasury bills, commercial papers, certificate of deposits and their merits and demerits. Now we will discuss about capital market. Capital market is very important in Indian financial system. Capital market is a market where buyers and sellers engage in trade of financial securities like bonds, stocks and etc. The buying and selling is undertaken by participants such as individuals and institutions. Okay, first we'll talk about market. What is a market? Market is a platform which enables the buyers and sellers to interact and transact. The transactions between the buyers and sellers is done by directly or through intermediaries. Capital market, it is a market where financial assets are traded. The trading between the buyers and sellers based on their financial assets, financial securities. The capital market has buyers, sellers and intermediaries. Here we can say the buyers are like entrepreneurs, newly business persons and sellers are banks. Banks are major suppliers of trading instruments. Intermediaries are stock brokers, agent brokers, all those things. For example, we can say financial securities are bonds, stocks, shares and debentures. Here I have one question. Who regulates the capital market? By whom the capital market is regulated by? Capital market is regulated by SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India. Whereas the money market is regulated by RBI. In the capital market, we have instruments like equity and debt. I can say a little easy. Equity is like a stocks and shares and debt is bonds. Equity is the selling of ownership of the company in the form of shares. In the equity, we can sell the company ownership, a part, some part of ownership of the company to the investors in the form of shares. In the debt, we are getting ascertain some loans directly from the investors of the company. These loans we have to repayable within specified time. Here in the debt marketing, we are not selling the ownership. In the equity, we are selling the ownership. But in the debt, we are getting some loans from the investors of the company. These loans we have to repay. Here we have the picture. Financial market, which is divided as a money market and capital market. In a money market, it is a maturity period is less than 1 year, it is a short term, and capital market, the maturity period is long term. In a money market, we'll get treasury bills, certificate of deposits and commercial papers. Capital market is divided again two types, primary market and secondary market. Primary market, new stocks, bonds or other securities that offered to the public by investment bankers. Here in the primary market, it releases new shares, it releases new financial assets to the public. In primary market, either the new company releases the shares or the old company which is already having the shares but the old company wants to expand its capital. These new releases shares comes under primary market. Primary market is also called as market for capital formation. Here we have two types of primary market issues. Initial public offering and season new issued. Here IPO process. How IPO, initial public offering, is processed? First, obtain the approval of it. Current shareholders, auditors and lawyers must also certify that all documents for the company are legitimate, then finds an investment bank who willing to underwrite the offering. The company files a registration statement with the security commissioner, which includes prospectus, that describes the key aspects of the issue, issuer and its management and financial position. After security commissioner approves the registration statement, the price of the offer to the public securities will be announced. The investment bankers and company executives promote the company's stock offering through a roadshow, a series of presentations to the potential investors around the country and sometimes overseas. Okay, here we have different steps for IPO process. First, we will take the current shareholders. The company is already having the shareholders. From that shareholders, we are taking some approvals. Here, the first one, obtain the approval of its current shareholders. We are taking the approval from its current shareholders. Next, auditors and lawyers must also certify that all documents of the company are legitimate. Whether that company particulars are correct, whether it is perfect or not, these are certified by the auditors and lawyers. Then find an investment bank who is willing to underwrite the offering. Generally, underwriting concepts will be done by banks only. So we will find out one investment bank who is willing to underwrite. The company files a registration statement with security commissioner. First, here this is the main important role. We have to take permission with the security commissioner, which includes that registration statement includes the issue, issuer and financial position of the company and its management. All those will include in the registration statement. Once security commissioner will approve the registration statement, the price offered by that company, price for the shares will be announced to the public securities. Next, the investment bankers and company executives promote the company stock offering through a series of presentations to potential investors around the country. Once the price for the shares, price for the public securities will be announced, then the bankers will execute to promote all those shares by giving some roadshows and series of presentations to their potential investors. Here, the functions of primary market. We have different functions here: origination, underwriting and distribution. Origination, from where shares are getting done. We are getting shares from which company. These are done in origination. Underwriting, generally banks are doing this underwriting conditions. Next, distribution, selling the shares to its potential investors. These are comes under distribution sector. Rights issue, generally in primary market we have three ways of operations. Those are public issue, rights issue and private place. In public issue, anyone can buy the shares, anyone can buy the financial securities, whereas in private sector it is mainly conducted at the stock exchanges. These private places are mainly, we can say, in stock exchanges. These are released for a group of, for a specified individuals and institutions. Rights issue. Rights issue is a dividend of subscription rights to buy additional securities in a company made to the company's existing security holders, shareholders. In the rights issue, already company is having some shareholders. For those shareholders, for those particular shareholders only, we are giving some securities. We are purchasing the securities. We are selling the securities only for those existing shareholders in the rights issue. The common public cannot buy these shares. In a public issue, anyone can buy the shares. Whereas in rights issue, no, only for the particular shareholders, only for the existing shareholders can buy this in the rights issue. When the rights are for equity securities, such as shares in a public company, is non-dilutive way to raise capital. Rights issues may be particularly useful for all publicly traded companies as opposed to other more dilutive financing options. Okay, we'll see. When the rights are for equity securities such as shares in public company, it is non-dilutive to raise capital. Some companies having some particular shareholders, they have limited shareholders. If they want to expand their capital, if they want to expand their financial assets, then they will sell only for those limited shareholders. Not for, they don't want to come new shareholders. They want to sell only for those limited shareholders. In the rights issue, it is possible. It will increase the rise of capital. It will increase their financial liquidity, and it is diluting. It is not diluting the public. With the limited shareholders only, they are increasing their capital. They are increasing their financial liquidity. Equity issues are generally preferable to debt issues from the company's viewpoint. In the company's viewpoint, companies usually opt for a rights issue in order to minimize dilution and maximize the useful life of tax loss carry forwards. Generally, companies were preferable to the rights issue only. Why? Because it is in order to dilution with a limited number of shareholders. They are maximizing their capital and minimizing their dilutions. Advantages of right issue. It gives existing shareholders securities called rights, which gives the shareholders to the right to purchase new shares at discount to the market price. For existing shareholders, we are giving some rights. They can purchase the new shares with a discount price, with a market price. They can purchase new shares with a discounted price. They have that right. Issue involves less flotation cost as the company can avoid the underwriting commission. Already once shareholders get into the company, they have underwritings previously. For that new purchasing of the shares, we can avoid the underwriting options. In case of profitable companies, the issue is more likely to be successful since the subscription price is set much below the current market price. Here, the shareholder has the right to purchase the discounted price. They can buy market price. Here, present market price is, although it is little bit more, they can get the shares with subscription price only. Here, features of primary market. This is the market for new long-term equity capital. As you know, capital market is a long-term equity only. The primary market is a market where securities are sold for first time. Here, we are selling the new securities from the company. Company is directly selling the products to the products which are shares to the investors directly. We are not selling the old shares. In primary issue, the securities are issued by the company directly to investors. Investors are getting the financial securities shares from the company directly. They are not getting with other intermediaries, is not there in primary market. The company receives the money and issues new security certificate to investors. Okay, here the investor is getting the financial security certificate, whereas the company receives the money from the investors. By this, company will expand their capability, expand their capacity and capital, whereas investor will get the security certificate from the company. Primary issues are used by companies for the purpose of setting new business or for expanding or modernizing the existing business. The main purpose for doing the primary market is to set up a new business. If they want to set up new business, they want to increase their capital. They want to get some shares with the public or for expanding or modernizing the existing business. Okay, for already existing business, if they want to modernize, if they want to expand their capital, then they will do for primary market. Next, secondary market. Trading of existing shares are done in secondary market. In the secondary market, already once companies sell to the financial securities to the investors, and again those securities are sell to another investors, then it is called secondary market. Trading is already done for the released shares. In the picture we can see here, company is selling shares to the investor A and company is getting money from investor A. This is directly company is selling to the investor A. This is called primary market. Here the investor A is selling to the investor B. So the investor B is not getting the shares or financial securities from investor, from the company, not from the, sorry, investor B is getting the shares from investor A, not from the directly company. So the investor B is called secondary market. Here investor A is called primary market. Because why? Because it is getting financial securities from the company. Here investor B is getting shares from investor A. Here in the secondary market commonly referred to as the stock market. This includes the New York Stock Exchange. It is the largest stock exchange, and Nasdaq, and all major exchanges all around the world. Secondary market is commonly referred as stock market. It is stock market type. This includes all major stock exchanges around the world. Here, stock market, investment in equity and stocks. It represents the ownership of corporation, no promissory returns, grants right to share in firm assets and earnings if any. Okay, you see, in stock market we are getting some ownership, we are getting some part of the ownership from the company. From the company ownership we are getting some part of the ownership. Here no promissory returns are there. In the stock market we are not getting the promised returns, whereas in the primary market we are getting fixed amount of financial securities, whereas in the secondary market we are not getting the promised returns. Here fluctuations will be there. Sometimes we will get higher amounts than we paid it for, otherwise we will get some less amount what we paid. Here we'll get right to share our assets and earnings. We have some right to share our earnings or our firm asset. You can see in the picture also here, investor A. Here investor A is buying from the company shares. Investor A is sharing. They have right to share its profit, its assets with the investor B. Investors are entitled to a particular percent of the firm after tax profit. Here we have retained earnings and dividends. Retained earnings, when we are getting the profit from the company, profit from that share, then we will keep aside some part. We are not keeping all the profitable income, we are keeping some profit for the latter use of the firm. Here we will see, firms do not pay all their after tax profit to shareholders. Some is kept for latter use of the firm. Okay, what we are getting from the shares, what we are getting from the initial profitable income from those shares, we are not giving all the amount to the shareholders. We are just keeping some part aside for the latter use, and remaining amount we are distributing to the shareholders. In dividend, the part of profit, what profit we are getting, is distributed to all shareholders. Aside from dividend, usually more important reason to holding stocks is to enjoy capital gains. Apart from these retained earnings and dividends, what we are, the main reason, the important reason to hold the stock market is to enjoy capital gains. Capital gains is return someone gets when they sell a stock at a higher price than they paid it for. In the capital gains, where the investor is getting higher price than what he paid for it. Sometimes we'll get most profitable income in the capital gains in the stock markets. Here we have some differences between the primary market and secondary market. Based on this comparison, we'll see meaning the place where fresh issue of shares is made. In the primary market, we are getting fresh financial securities are getting directly from the companies, not from the other investors. So it is freshly issued securities. Whereas in the secondary market place where pre-issued securities are dealt with, here already released shares are dealt in the traded in the secondary market. So it is pre-issued securities. Another name, new issue market for the primary market. Here we have one more, we can say one more thing. Primary market is also called as a market for capital formation, and for secondary market it is gold issue market. Type of purchasing. In primary market we can purchase directly, whereas in the secondary market we are purchasing indirectly. How many times a security can be sold? In the primary market we can sell only once. Means the company is selling only once for the investors. Whereas in the secondary market we have the right to multiple times of assets price. Here in the primary market we have fixed price. In the secondary market it is fluctuates, depends on supply and demand force. In the secondary market it will be fluctuates. Sometimes we will get higher price, sometimes it is less what we are paid for. Here we have questions which are related to the capital market. We'll see which organization regulates the capital market. Capital market is regulated by SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India. How many types of industrial security market? We have two types of industrial security markets. Those are primary market and secondary market. In primary market, property of shares, which made it easy to sell newly issued securities considered as. In the primary market, newly issued securities are considered as. What it is considered? It will increase the liquidity. It will increase the financial capital. The company's capital is to be expanded by giving the primary market. Hence, the answer is increase the liquidity. Option A. In capital market, major supplies of trading instruments are. In the capital market, major supplies are government and corporations. Option is A. In case of IPO grading, investment recommendations are expressed by. In initial public offering, it is graded by all the things. Buying, we can buy the processes. Initial public offerings like our shares, we can hold them, we can sell. Hence the option is D, any of the above. We can buy, we can hold, or we can sell the financial securities. Which regulates the Indian corporate debt market? Indian corporate debt market is regulated by the SEBI, Securities Board of Exchange in India. Thank you for watching. Thanks to Prasad sir. Please like and subscribe us for more topics like this.